Namaste. Thank you for joining me this morning. As always, please practice according to your condition and your comfort level. Feel free to do the variations if you know them, if you're comfortable with them. Otherwise, please modify and please respect your limitations. So let's begin. Close your eyes. Bring your attention inward. Before creation, what existed? God was there in the midst of it all. At the beginning, and God will still be there even past the end of this universe. Attune your consciousness to that supreme divine essence now. Fix your mind on God alone. Rest your thoughts in God alone. And in God you will live hereafter. Of this there is no doubt. May all beings everywhere be happy and free from suffering and enjoy this practice of our senses. May we acquire a strong desire for liberation from pain and suffering. And may we cherish no ill feelings against each other. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Let's do the mantra for purification now. If you know it, you can do it along with me. If not, just imagine you're chanting it through the voice of the guru and you derive all the benefits of the purification of the space, the grounds, and all the psychic channels within. Om Pavitraha Pavitra Va Sava Vashtanga Topi Va Yaha Smrit Pandrikaksham Savaya Bihantraha Saji. Om Pavitraha Pavitra Vasa Vashtanga Topi Vayaha Smrit Pandrikaksham Sabaya Bhyantraha Sji. Om Pavitraha Pavitra Vasa Vashtanga Topi Vayaha Smrit Pandrikaksham Sabaya Bhyantraha Sji. So let's do color breathing now, or sound breathing. So imagine, as you might have heard, the Om is made up of all colors, sounds, and vibrations of the universe. Imagine we're breaking down the Om and its individual constituents. Together, they form an aura that helps protect us against negative attacks, psychic attacks, negative energy being directed towards us, either intentionally or unintentionally. And this brings about healing effects too. Your attention is like a magnet, so when you bring your attention there with the intention of healing, this will manifest in a positive way, for in a healing way. So we're just concentrating on different areas of the body and chanting the sound associated with it. So let's start off the lower three chakras, located at the base of the spine, the root of the base of the spine, the sacral area, and the navel. The color is red. Sound is ah. Inhale. Ah. Next, go up to the heart. The color is green. In doing this, we bring about mental, physical, and spirit, and emotional and spiritual healing of the heart. Inhale. Color is you. Color is green. The sound is you. Inhale. You. Inhale. out to the base of the throat now. The color is blue. The sound is soul. May all words that come out of the throat always be ones of loving kindness and compassion. Inhale. The space between the eyebrows now, the color is indigo, the sound is sun, S-U-N. As you're doing this, concentrate mostly on the end part, this hum, the part that sounds like a hum, and that will produce the vibrations that will help to dislodge all the impurities from wherever they sit in the body, and bring them, imagine them going out in the bloodstream and being carried out of the body. Again, the color indigo, the sound sun. Inhale. Sun. To the crown now, the color is violet, sound of sum. Again, concentrate on the M part of the sound that will help to produce vibrations to help improve mental sharpness and clarity. Inhale, sum. That again, move your attention again to the crown, the color violet. Sum. Inhale for mental sharpness. Sum. Clear and sharp. Let's begin the practice. And with that mindset, try to always think of God during the practice. Make this a divine offering to all beings everywhere. For God is the God manifests in all beings everywhere. Equal portion of God found in every being. So let's celebrate that. Let's celebrate the richness and the beauty and the magnificence of God through all the imitation of the forms. Let's come to standing. Starting off with spiritual breathing. Bring the feet about 10 inches apart. Bring the arms up, the palms slightly turned up. From the fingertips, inhale through the arms down into the spiritual heart. Hold the attention and the breath at the heart. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale out through the arms. 2, 3, 4. Watch your breath moving. 6, 7, 8. Inhale, imagine the breath, the best of best coming in through the arms. Breathe it in. 2, 3, 4. Right into the heart. 6, 7, 8. Hold again the heart, hold the breath. Exhale, just the breath leaves out of the arms, everything else stays in. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, last time. Bring all that you need, attract it there with your attention into the heart. 2, 3, 4. Pull it down through the arms. 6, 7, 8. Holding all in the heart, hold the breath. Make it an offering to God and to all beings as a result. Exhale now out through the arms. Just a breath again leaves. 2, 3, 4, 5. bring the arms down. Let's continue with the exercises and through the exercises we produce heat that helps to remove more impurities from the body. So do the exercise with energy, with vigor, do the breathing with enthusiasm. Inhale, sweep the arms up and down, up, down. Inhale, straight up, spread the fingers. Exhale, pull them down. Form fists as you pull them down. In front of the body, same movement with the hands. Reach out, retract. And release. Arm swings. Throw the arms behind the ears. Arms across the chest. Imagine you're trying to squeeze your armpits together. Exhale, throw the arms back. The inhale happens as you come back into the center. And release. Now bring your arms up overhead on the inhale. Exhale, toss the body down. Light, easy swings of the body. One more. Just stay down, let the body stop bouncing and shaking. And then roll your way back up. Next one. Coming into squat. So just come down as far as you can comfortably. Don't respect the limitation of your knees. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, pull down into squat. And right back up. Take the elbows out to the side. We're going to twist from side to side. We complete the exhales. We twist to each side. We come back to the center. That's when you inhale. Again with the squat, so again just come down as far as you can comfortably. Four movements. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, down. Inhale, pop back up. Exhale, swing the arms down. Arms come out in front of the body, the height of the shoulders. Inhale, circle around backwards to the front, full circle. Exhale, pull in and punch right back out. Now drop the arms by the sides of the body. Same movement, but a circle and a quarter. Inhale, all the way to the front. Exhale, pull and then drop the arms right back down. And release. Open up the feet now a little bit. The toes pointing out to the side. Left arm up, inhale. Exhale, bend to the right. Right arm up, inhale. Exhale, bend to the left. Center. Next one, the movement's the same, but the breathing's a little bit different. Left arm up, inhale. Go to the right, hold the breath. Go a little bit deeper if you can. Then exhale, come back up. Right arm up, inhale. Reach over to the left and go a little bit deeper as you hold the breath. Exhale, return. Continue. Allow the breath to ride the breath. Allow the breath to carry you nice and long into the pose. Try not to make folds in the underside of the body as you bend. And stretch the upside of the body as much as you can. Lose yourself in the sensations. Imagine all beings experiencing this through your body. So make the experience as beneficial as possible. The perfect balance of strength and drive and effort with softness and surrender. Watching the body moving all by itself. And keep attuning to the essence of the divine presence within, who sees everyone and all beings with unconditional love and non-judgment. From the foot right to the fingertips. Let's do one more on each side. Inhale, reach, stretch, fold, lean. Coming up, and go to the other side. Hold the breath so you can go a little bit deeper still. Onto the hands and knees now. Cat, cow. Inhale, arch the back. Exhale, round the back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, stretch the belly skin. Exhale, stretch the back skin. Inhale. Inhale, telescope the neck out of the shoulders, no folds across the lower back. Exhale. Make sure you don't close off the airway on the exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, push the belly button and the chest forward and down. Exhale, throw them up through the back body, through the lower back and between your shoulder blades with the heart. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, push our forward away from the seat, exhale, inhale, exhale, and come back to neutral back. Raise your right leg up to starting position. Exhale, swing it out to the right. On the inhale, just throw the leg up there. The head comes up as well. Again, do a core into condition. No jerky, abrupt move of aggressive movements. Swing out to the right, left. Loosen up the hip. onto the belly. Anchor down to the lower body from the hips and the thighs, the hips and the thighs and the tops of the feet. Join the hands behind the back. We're going to lift the chest. On the inhale, come down. As you lift, engage the buttocks and the upper back. Up and down. Exhale. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Press the hip bones up and down. And the thighs up. Body, inhale, exhale, drain all the fatigue out of the body. Now bring the arms forward, a couple of options. You can raise the legs and the arms up and then come back down and just inhale, exhale. That's option one. If you have a little bit more strength, you can throw the legs up, and then as the body comes down, the action of the body, the legs and the chest and the hips coming down, we'll throw the upper body up like this. Going. Breathe in and breathe out. Relax. Now come back into child's pose, a seat on the heels. Inhale, coming up into high cat. Exhale, cobra, chest forward, the hips between the hands. Inhale, back up in the high cat. Exhale, seat behind the heels. Inhale, roll up. Exhale, forward, head up, inhale, back up, exhale, seat back, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, all the way back, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Imagine a wave emerging from the ocean, up, reaching the full heights, starting to crest, and flatten and disappear back in the water. Inhale. Exhale. Imagine, see right through your skin and see the spine. Always keeping that curve ever smooth, no kinks anywhere along the way, at the lower back or the back of the neck, up. Forward. Inhale, exhale, inhale, round your back, up the chin, exhale, lower back down, then up, rounding, then flexing, arching, rounding again, flattening and lengthening, then up, forward, lose yourself in the sensations. Inhale. Forward. Exhale. Watch the body move gracefully, and then the body will feel even better as you do this. Up. Forward. The body will feel powerful, graceful, and then up and back. And rest in child's pose for a moment. Breathe in. Breathe out. Next, we're going to slide forward into cobra. So push the elbows up to the side, inhale, glide forward, two hands. Lift the head, bring it back, and hold the breath, hold the pose. Make sure you don't jam up the shoulder, the ear. the neck. Tell us to make out the shoulders. Exhale all the way back. Inhale, glide forward, or you can come forward into baby plank, place hips down, and then just uncoil the head, allow the head to go back. Hold the breath here. Hold the pose. Exhale back, all the way back down. Choose your preferred ascent. Inhale, come up. Hold the head up high. Copy the movement of the snake. Copy it physically, mentally as well. Be regal and wise. And back, exhale. And inhale. Come forward. Hold the breath, everything stops. All the fluctuations of the mind, the body movements, and even the emotions as though they were frozen. And back, exhale. Inhale. Show up in every pose an offering, a divine expression of love to the highest self. And back, exhale. Inhale, come forward, smoothly and gracefully. Bring your head up high, try to see God in all the forms, all the magnificent ways that with grace and beauty and His magnificence manifests. Back, exhale. This time, if you like, see if you can pull the feet up towards the head. Come on, your fingertips get more height, and feel as though you're squeezing socks behind your knees. If you can't touch your head, don't worry about it, just do your best. Just work the legs a little bit. And back, exhale. Inhale. Want to move all the joints every day to keep them healthy and strong. All the joints. All working together like a fine-tuned orchestra. Inhale. Come up. Hold the breath. And lift the palms up to get a little more height. Really press into your fingertips. And back. Exhale. Inhale. Rise up. Shoulders back. Chest fully open. And back. Exhale. Let's do one more. Inhale. Come forward. Come up. Everything stops again. In that moment of stillness, the mind is calm. Keep the mind calm even when the body is moving. And relax. Feet down behind the heels. Breathe in. Breathe out. Try not to change your temperament and keep it calm and quiet. Now come onto your belly, roll onto your back. Inhale, stretch the arms over the head, reach out through the heels, the toes. Exhale, come into tuck, squeeze the knees in towards the shoulders, the forehead towards the knees. Inhale, lay out again, stretch out long. Hold the breath up, that's right. Exhale, come back into the tuck. Inhale, extend. Inhale, stretch. Hold the navel. Exhale, push the thighs in towards the abdomen. The knees between the forehead, the forehead between the knees. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Everything, all the muscles moving towards the center of the body. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale, stretch out. This time, hold the breath as you tuck. Squeeze the outer legs as the elbows. Try to get your shoulders up to your knees, your forehead up to the thumbs, over your knees. Exhale, release. Inhale, stretch out. Bring the breath and tuck. Bring all the attention to the space between the eyebrows. If you can't, your forehead to your thumbs. Just keep your attention there. Exhale, train your mind to be one-pointed. Inhale, stretch out. Hold your breath and tuck.
everything stops again. All movements, the mind, body, and emotions, everything quiet. Inhale. Hold the breath and tuck and try to stay in that state all the way throughout the practice and all through all the daily challenges, day-to-day life. Release, exhale. Inhale, stretch out. Hold the breath and tuck. And release, exhale. Inhale, extend. Hold and tuck. Make your body look like a fist. Come up very tight and compact. Exhale, release. Inhale, stretch. Fingers and toes even. Hold the breath and tuck. The whole body singing, everything participating in this. In this practice. And one more. Inhale, stretch out. Hold the breath and tuck. Hold everything up and in. And release. Breathe in. Breathe out. Let go of all fatigue. Let go of all effort. Now I'm going to just rock up and down. So if you like, you can, if you have more strength, you can pull your legs up over your head into plow position. And then bring your legs back down as feet come down. Keep your heels down as you lift up into seated and pull your body down over your legs in Paschimottanasana. Otherwise, you can modify by just rolling back and forth and just use momentum so the legs come down to sit up. So just roll on your back. Oh. And make the movements as nice and graceful as possible. Move at an even speed and no jerky movements, no crash landings of your legs or your back on the ground to come down. Smooth. Use the breath to carry you through the movement softly and fluidly. The legs straight. You're doing the full version of the pose, going to Halasana and into Paschimottanasana. And let's just do one more. Full one. And then we come back onto your back. Again, bring the legs over your head so we can pull out. And come into standing position. Prepare to stand, bend your knees. Touch your feet and smoothly come up. Okay, so now make your way to the front of the mat. Continue to warm up. Surya Namaskara. So let's come to the front of the mat and start. Remember to renounce the fruits of the practice makes practice even more meaningful. Pretend this, or imagine this as your divine duty to all beings everywhere. Do it because it must be done for the benefit of all. Surya Namaskar. Raise your arms up over the head. Imagine the sun shining down you, the light and the warmth representing the wisdom and the love of God. Right foot back into a lunge. Sink down to the seat. Come into high plank. Knees, chest, forehead down. Glide between your arms. Make your way to cobra. Shoulders back. Roll over your toes back into downward facing dog. Allow the heart to melt between the shoulder blades. Look between the hands, right foot forward. If that's difficult, lower your knee down. If the foot doesn't make it all the way, use your right foot to step it forward. Sink down to the seat, push the seat in. And then bring your feet together, chest on the thighs, head down again. Come all the way to standing salute. Hands back to the heart. Don't worry about the breath. Just move the body in a way that feels natural and comfortable. Keeps the breath steady and even. Fold down over your legs. Left foot back. The breath will figure it out. And deliver fluidity and ease of movement. Knees, chest, forehead down. And glide to your arms. A
helps go the trunk out of the hips and neck out of the shoulders. Create space back into downward facing dog. Left leg now steps forward between the hands, sink down to the seat, and then bring the left right foot in to meet the left. Fold the body in half over your legs. Come right up to standing, reach up and back. As you see fit, head to the heart. Arms up over the head, create space. Approach to nature, which is boundless, formless, infinite. Uttanasana. Right foot back, sink down to the seat. Into the plank. Ashtanga Namaskara. And right through to the cobra. Link the moves together seamlessly. Back into downward facing dog. Imagine doing a divine dance of devotion and love. Right foot forward, all for God, all for all beings. Chest on the sides, head down. Come right up. And hands back to the heart. Reach up again. Watch the body moving in your mind. Gracefully. Left foot back. Picture yourself in a practice you're trying to access. Just do your best. The body will obey and just manifest what you're trying to. The body will end up in the position. So, like, can't even remember which foot it was now. Let's bring the left foot forward. I have to forget that that was my head of self and down. Come all the way up to standing. Hands back to the heart. Reach up and back. Fold forward. Chest on the sides, head down. Left foot back, switching up into high plank, lower down knees, chest, forehead, come forward into your cobra, back into Adho Mukha Svanasana, and step the right foot forward to the hands. Have no expectations, open your mind up to all possibilities, pull wide down onto your legs, come standing, reach up and back, return home, hands to the heart. And up, arms over the head, come down into Uttanasana. Lift the head and chest, press into your hands, and you can either jump or walk back into Chaturanga, hovering just above the ground, through into upward facing dog. If it's too much, keep your hips on the ground to cobra. If you're doing upward facing dog, try to pulse a little bit, try to get your hips high away from the ground as much as possible. Push your chest forward, your head back. Make like a dog howling at the moon. Think of that in your mind and try to imitate the movement and the being. Now roll over your toes back into downward facing dog. Allow the heart to sink down towards the ground. Pulse here a little bit, try to melt through the heart. If the shoulders come closer to the ground without bending the arms if possible. If you're very flexible, maybe your forehead, maybe your nose, maybe your chin eventually comes down to the ground. Exhibit the loyalty of the dog to its master. Getting ready to come forward. Lift the heels, bend the knees, look between your hands. Bring your feet forward, hopping or walking. Pull the body down onto your legs, head close to the feet. Come right up to standing, reach up and back. Hands back to the heart, tap into the consciousness of the movements. So you go back into these open heart opening poses, open yourself up to divine grace. As you fold down with the head down and the eyes downcast, a gesture of humility and surrender. Lift hand, chest, press into your hands. Bend your elbows to come down so you don't land heavily. Land light as a feather. Come up into upward facing dog. Now roll over your toes, round your back. Right back into downward facing dog. This oscillate between these two poses. Round your back, roll over your toes, just between your hands and coil. And back the other way. Round your back and then sink the heart. One more time, roll forward. Again, try not to make any folds in the lower back or the back of the neck. Roll over your toes, back into downward facing dog. From here, lift the heels, bend the knees, and between your hands. Bring your feet softly forward, pull the body down onto your legs. Come all the way up to standing, reach up and back. heads back to the hearts.
Raise your arms up, go back.
Go down, moving a little bit faster now. Lift the head and chest, shoulders up the fingertips, back into chaturanga, or onto your belly into upward facing dog or cobra. Then roll your toes back into downward facing dog. Keep watching the body moving, lift the heels, bend the knees. Move your feet to your hands, hopping or walking. Pull the body down onto your legs. Come up. Bury your mind deep in the heart. And watch the body move with even more steadiness and grace and ease.
And one more time. Reach up and back.
Go down softly. Fold the body in half. Bow into the legs. Inhale, lift the head and chest. Back into chaturanga. Right through into the cobra or your upward facing dog. Move your toes back into downward facing dog. Lift up the heels, bend the knees to the hands. Bring your feet forward and push your body against the legs, head down. Come right up to standing. Reach up and back. Bring the hands back to the heart. Take pause here for a moment. Breathe in from the heart up to the space between the eyebrows. Exhale back down to the heart. Remain established firmly in love for all beings. Connect mind, body, and spirit together so that all actions, thoughts, and words always come from a place of love and compassion. Good. So now, let's do Shiva Namaskara, salutation to that which transforms and brings about rebirth. Rebirth and transformation. Raise your arms up over the head, reach up high, press the hips forward, lean back as far as you see fit. Fold down over your legs, chest on your thighs, bend your knees if you need to keep your belly on your connected to your thighs. You can take any version you like. You can take your opposite elbows here, you can slide your hands down the backs of the legs, the calves, and then pull your body against the legs. If you're very flexible, maybe your legs are straight, your seat over your heels, you can bring your forehead down and press against the shins. Good, now bring your hands down from here, press into your hands, back into chaturanga or onto your belly, walk or hop back into cobra or upward facing dog, shoulders back, head high. Pull over your toes back into downward facing dog. And then the left foot steps forward to the hands. Lower the knee down, sink down to the seat. Raise your arms up over the head. If you like, you can start with holding your opposite elbows and push your seat down and forward towards the front heel. Allow the head to just press into the arms. Lean away from the leg. If you like, you can extend your arms fully. Make sure you don't bend your elbows. Keep them close to the head so the arms stay straight. Think of a crescent moon shape. Rock the shoulders back and forth. Try to get a little bit more opening. Heart lifts. A divine expression of devotion. And then bring the hands back down to your front knee. Press up a little bit more upright. Your front leg like a box. Your legs like a box. Open up to your right. Extend the arms out to the shoulders. Sukha Virabhadrasana. Stay strong and steady. Good. Now take your left hand down to the ground and front to the foot. Right arm straight up. Sukha Trikonasana. Here you have the option to take the right hand behind the back. Drop your shoulder a little bit. Still keep it pressed against the knee and bring the left arm underneath. Then from here you can hold the fingers, lock the fingers together, or hold the right wrist. It's beside the seat, not over the seat. It's just beside your left hip against the thigh. Roll the right shoulder back. Those of you who want can take the back knee up off the ground and see if you can straighten up the right leg. Raise the hip, come into bound triangle. The head close to the ground. Look over your right shoulder. Doesn't matter if you can't get your left leg straight. Just keep pushing your shoulder against the knee.
from here, release, bring hands back down, step back in the high plank, lower down, Ashtanga Namaskara, or you can do your Chaturanga
through into Cobra, or Upward Facing Dog. Roll over your toes back into Downward Facing Dog, listening to the heart. Then bring the right foot forward, lower the seat, right down, lower the knee, raise your arms up again. You can start with your head just pressing into the arms and lean away from the leg. Drop the seat all the way forward. Just keep pulling on your elbows, trying to get your body to telescope out of the hips. And then you can straighten your arms if you like, hands in Kali Mudra. The mudra that that reflects fearlessness and fierceness. Lift the chest. Crescent shape moon, radiate your inner light. And then come back up, lead to the heart, turn your hands to your knee to press yourself up. Turn to your left, your legs like a box. Arms up to the side for Sukha Virabhadrasana, strong line here. Come as the consciousness of a warrior. Then from here, dip down, the right hand down, left hand up, straight line from hand to hand, press the left shoulder back. You can stay like this if you like. Keep trying to get your left shoulder all the way back so your shoulders line up on top of the other. Or drop down a little bit, your shoulder against the knee, lean down so you can get the whole right arm underneath your leg, left arm goes over your back, and just throw it down into your right, receiving hand, your right hand. Left shoulder back. From here, if you like, you can bend the toes under, lift the back knee, push the left hip up and back to straighten the leg. Again, eventually maybe the right leg will straighten. If it doesn't, don't worry about it. Keep pressing the back of the shoulder into the knee. Lengthen the spine from the hip all the way down to the head. And then release, come back, facing forward, back into high plank. Knees, chest, forehead down, and through to Cobra. Shoulders back, head back. Roll over your toes, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Melt the heart. Left foot steps forward to the hands, back foot flat, Virabhadrasana 1. Raise your arms up, bring the head back behind the arms. Straight line from the base spine right to the fingertips. Show the devotion of the warrior. Devoted always to the people, always ready to do the service. Now from here, lean forward, press your belly towards your front thigh, come up into warrior three. If it's too much, if you lose your balance, you can take your index fingers down to the ground, out to the side like an airplane is another option. Make your body level like a table, like you're lying on a table. If you want to go further, join your hands behind the back, interlace your fingers, toppling tree. Try to get your hands over your shoulders, curve your spine, but bring your right leg up higher. Your chest forward. Good. From here, if you can, drop your left hand down, turn to the right, coming into Ardha Chandrasana. So if that's too much, you can come down onto your left knee if you can't quite reach the ground and don't have a block. Okay, so you can do. From here, as a modification, be more flexible, you can take the foot, press the foot into your hand away from your seat. Look over your right shoulder. If you want, you can look down in front. Keep your left hip over the left heel. And see if you can bring your left hand up to your heart. Okay, so again, according to your condition and abilities. From here, bring left hand down if you need to. Step the right foot back down into warrior two. Sink down to the seat. Strong lines again. Come back into the warrior consciousness. Stay with that mindset of bravery, determination all throughout the practice. Be fearless. And come back into high plank. We're down, Ashtanga Namaskara. Come forward to your Cobra. shoulders back, head back. Roll over your toes, back into downward facing dog. Now bring the right foot forward, back foot flat. If it's too much, if you can't square off your hips, you can lift the back heel. You can do it like this. Keep the back leg strong. Make sure you're not sagging through the back of the knee. Press the back knee up. Okay, so in whatever foot position you'd find. Now from here, lean forward, bring weight into the front foot, and bring the right leg up. Warrior three, take whatever position you want with your hands that's suitable for you. You can make your way to toppling tree. Interlace your fingers, open up the palms, bring your hands over the shoulders, bring your left foot up higher. Curve your spine. Release the hands, drop the right hand down from the foot, lower down on your knee if you need to. Turn to your left, Adho Chandrasana. Want, can bring a foot into your hand, push the foot away from your seat, try to get your knee to point up. Keep your left shoulder back, or bring your left shoulder back. If you want, you can look down in front, make sure your right hip is over the right heel, and if you want, you can try to take your head off the ground to your heart. From here, gracefully back into warrior two. Just watch the body moving all by itself. Come back into high plank. From here, push the hips back. Move your left hand towards the right, Vasisthasana. You can cross, your ankles will cross here as you come into Vasisthasana. You can stay like this. If it's too much, lower down on your left knee. If you want to go further, you can slide your right toes back alongside the right left knee and push your hips up, come into wild thing. If you know the variations, go ahead. Your left foot flat on the ground, your foot at 45 degrees. You push into your left hand. You can, might be able to take your knee up, maybe even the foot. If you know the variation, go ahead. If not, just again, move according to your abilities and condition. You have to keep your hip nice and high. Left foot flat on the ground. And then release, come back down, back into downward facing dog. First in the plank, downward facing dog, get your hips nice and high to start the movement. Right hand towards the left, spin towards your left, come up into your Vasisthasana, push your hips forward. Feels like you're being a kite, being blown from the wind from behind. You want to go further, slide your left toes back onto the knee, shorten your base a little bit, bring your left foot, the right foot in a little bit, press the base of the big toe down. Keep steady on your hand, make sure you don't fall into your shoulder. If your hips are high, you might be able to take your left knee up more easily. If you have the reach, take hold of the foot. Again, this is just for those who feel comfortable in this variation, go ahead. Want to explore it. And back down gracefully. High plank, downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out, soften. So from here, if you want, you can move to the front of the mat. You can hold the edge of the mat and see if you can get your head down to the ground. Below the arms. Keep pulling on the edge of the mat. Your head comes down, maybe between somewhere between your hands and your right left your feet. Raise right leg up now. Now if you feel comfortable, do so, you can slide your left hand back. Take hold of the inside heel, step on your heel if you have the flexibility. To the reach, or bring it to the inside of the leg, or maybe to the outside, even alongside the body. So, any variation again you like. Concentrate. Watch
your body moving to the pose. Imagine yourself in the form, and perhaps the body will obey. And try the other leg. Right leg down. Right leg down, and then the left leg comes up. Try to get the foot up as high as you can. Push the belly towards the thigh. Keep pulling on the edge of the mat if you have it, and then take your right hand back. Maybe step on the fingers with your heel, or bring your hand anywhere. If your head is not on the ground, just try your best. It requires a little bit more balance, coordination. Keep looking forward, and then maybe you can take your arm up. Just move into expression that you can. And then come back down. Back into downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now from here, lift the heels, bend the knees. Jump forward or walk to your hands. Uttanasana again. Pull the body down against the legs. Hug the body to your legs. Take again the expression of Uttanasana you like. Push your body against the legs so that your legs maybe eventually straighten. Keep your chest with your thighs. Then from here, release. Come all the way up to standing. Arms up over the head. And the Kali Mudra. Push your shoulders back. You can just keep your hips forward, your chest up. You can stay like this if you feel comfortable. You can lean back a little bit. So you have to push your hips forward, really bring weight into your feet. Anchor down to the feet and go back as far as you feel fit. Feel as though you're made of elastic. Let your fingers come maybe right down to the ground behind your feet. Again, always just imagine yourself in a pose and doing what you can. All the way back up. Bring the hands back to the heart. From the heart, inhale up to the space between the eyebrows. Exhale back down to the heart. Remove all expectations, all attachments to the results. Just keep doing the practice as a divine duty towards all beings. And release. Okay, so now we're going to come down. The middle of the mat, maybe actually towards the back end of the mat for a headstand. If you know how to get into headstand, please go ahead. And just when you get up there, just try to find your focus at the space between your eyebrows. Leave the body by itself in stillness. If you want other modifications that are a little bit more accessible, you can just bring your head down, forehead to the ground from the knees, and maybe lift up your seat until your hips are over your knees. If you feel too much stretch or too much discomfort in the back of the neck, you just move your head forward and you stay on the top of the head. Push the belly button right through the lower back. You can try other things too. Bring your head forward from the knees, bring your fingertips back on either side of the mat, beyond the edge of the mat, press into your fingertips, lift up your seat so you have a wide triangular base. Walk your feet a little bit further forward towards your hands and bring one leg back. Bend the leg that's behind you very deeply so the heel's coming towards the seat. Flex your toes. And from here you can push up off your heel. Keep pressing into your fingertips. Press into the top of the head, close the hairline, and then just bend your toes back. So your toes just kind of flip away from the ground and then you're up. Your foot's always there close to the ground, so you can put it down whenever you need to. Do this mindfully. If you jump up very fast, you might land on your back. Eventually, you can bring your left foot back a little bit further, and your right foot up if you're confident, or your other foot in front a little bit up higher. Squeeze the thigh against the belly. Keep your toes bent back. This engages the muscles and core to keep you in balance. Again, always according to your comfort level. Don't force your mind into a place of anxiety or your body into a place of pain. This is not what you want to transmit. Remember, what you're feeling now is to an extent affecting everyone. So try to feel good, try to feel confident and secure, and the body feels comfortable and steady. way down softly and come down into child's pose. Breathe in, breathe out. Roll your way up, find your way onto your back. So you scoot to the front of the mat now. So you go back into halasana, you have still some room behind you. So roll back, press into your arms, send your legs over your head, behind your head. So you can walk your hands together, join your hands together. You can get your heels, your palms together, even better. Your hips right over your shoulders. Bring your hands onto your back. Heels, your palms resting at the mid-back. Fingers facing towards the seat. And keep your knees close to the ground, shoulders if you like. Or if you feel comfortable, extend your legs out, one or both legs at a time. Try to get your toes on the same line as your chin. Push up, elbows close together behind the back as much as possible. Now you can stay here. If you have a lotus, go ahead. Use your hands to help if you need to. Just bring your feet a little bit closer to your knees closer to your head. And make your way into the lotus. Try to push your knees up higher so your hips are, your knees are higher than your hips. Have the balance of your right on top of your shoulders. You can bring your hands to your thighs, either with your legs straight or lotus. Bring your attention to the space between your eyebrows again. Everything stops. Just try to merge with God in all the forms. Try to see again that divine essence that resides in all beings, as much as it resides in you. From here, plow pose. If you have a lotus, you can bring a lotus against your chest. If you know the full pose, go ahead and wrap your arms around the outside of the legs and join your hands underneath the seat. If you have your legs straight, just bring your feet back down into halasana and lower, if you like, the knees down towards the shoulders, your thighs against your chest. And squeeze your knees beside your, on either side of the head. Go deeper within, beyond the body, the mind, and the emotions. Withdraw from the senses. Okay, when you come out, just bring your hands behind your back, flat on the ground, palms down. Keep your legs close to the body as you come down. Try not to land with a big heavy thud. If your seat lands on your wrists, you just bring your feet down if you want all the way, or stop midway. Push your elbows a little bit further closer behind, underneath your body, then press into your forearms, fish pose. Push your chest up as high as you can. Allow the head to drop back so the top head finds the ground, perhaps. And from here, last streak of breath, breathe very fast in those like a sniffing dog. Now bring your knees down, your feet down close to the seat here. Keep your hands out from underneath. If your legs are down on the ground, just slide them in. Now you can, if you feel comfortable, bring your fingertips beside either side of the head and a little bit in front, lift your seat up. Slide your head back a little bit more towards your feet. Prepare for Urdhva Dandasana. Flip your hands around so your fingers are facing towards your heels. Fingers slightly turned outwards. You can stay on your head or take a half breath in and lift your head up off the ground. Lift your heels up. And stretch, try to get your arms and legs stretch. Urdhva Dandasana, if this is too much, do bridge pose. So from bridge pose, place your head, back of the head, and your shoulders on the ground. Just lift your seat, try to get your chest towards your chin, your knees, back your knees in line with your heels. Stay in this pose if you like. Good. You're in Urdhva Dandasana.
rock back and forth a few times. Try to get your chest in front of your arms. Try to straighten your legs and arms. Form a nice strong arch. Bring your heels down. Feel comfortable, those in whatever position, either bridge or Urdhva Dhanurasana. You can try to bring your left leg up. And then back down. And then the other leg, bring your right knee up into the chest and then raise your leg up straight. You can do this from your bridge again if you like. Support, bring your hands onto your seat if you need to. Support the hips. And back down. From here, lower the head back down. Relax on your back. Breathe in. Breathe out all fatigue. Sigh it all out. Good. Now from here, sit up any which way you like to come up. Paschimottanasana. You can bend your knees if you're very tight in the hamstrings. Bring the legs up. Not the legs, the arms up. Inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Try to reach for as much as you can so your chest comes to the knees. You can take hold of your opposite elbows and just hug your thigh, your body to your thighs. With each inhale, try to imagine your chest is trying to go beyond your knees. With each exhale, pull more weight into your legs. If you can get your legs flat on the ground, don't waste your time, go ahead. You can join your hands in front of your heels if you like. Take your attention to the base of the spine. Inhale, keep telescoping your chest forward. Keep reaching your head towards the fronts of the feet. Exhale. Allow the weight of the body to bring more release into the backs of the legs. All the attention to the base of the spine. Your attention might attract all the blood there and create some pulsations in that area of the base of the spine. Imagine that it's energy trying to rise up, trying to unleash and come right up the spine to the crown. Inhale and chest lift. Come back, hands facing back behind. You can do Parvottanasana or bench pose. For Parvottanasana, just slide heels in slightly and then push your hips up, roll the thighs in towards the mat so you can get your toes down. Move your feet as close as you need to get your toes down. Roll. You have to roll the thighs in. Try to get your chest up higher than the shoulders. Allow the head to go back. If this is too much, walk your feet in a little bit so that your heels are underneath your knees. Bench pose. Now bust your good breath. Breathe very fast to the nose like a sniffing dog. Tuck your chin in, lower your seat down. Hug your legs to the body, inhale. Exhale. Relax. Cross your ankles, come onto your hands and knees. From here, raise right leg up, tiger. Try to keep your legs straight, push your head forward, and push your heart forward away from your seat so you get a nice lengthy through the lower back, no crunching through the lower back. If you like, you can bend your knee, take hold of the foot with your left hand and pull it up higher. Those who are more flexible, have the shoulder mobility, you can take your foot in your left, in your right hand, hold the outside of the foot. The fingers come wrap around the outside of the foot, the thumb to the base of the toes, and then you bring your elbow up high so that when you move it forward, it's not straining the joint. And then pull your foot up higher if you want. You can bring your foot to your head, bring your head back. So different options. And just keep your leg up, okay, without binding. It's all good. Then release. be like a proud tiger. Keep your left leg straight. Try not to bend it. Make it, keep the leg engaged, strong. You can stay like this or bend your knee again. The raised leg and take the right arm back and take hold of the foot and pull it up as high as you can. Arch your back, push your chest forward. Or again, if you want to try the other one, again, take the fingers around the outside of the foot, the thumb pressing into the base of the toes. Bring your elbow up higher than the shoulder, and then move your elbow forward. And from here, you can bring the head up and bring your toes to your head, or just bring your leg up high as you can. Be mindful of your limits again, your mobility. And release. Come back onto your seat, bring your legs out in front. Just keep your legs outstretched. Make sure your heels don't go one from the other. Left hand's the outside of the right shin, and right hand behind your back, just to get center of the back. Try not to lean back. Sit forward and upright, inhale, lift up, exhale, turn to your right. Again, the right heel might slide forward at the left. Try to keep your heels together, flex your feet. Keep pushing against the outer shin. Shoulders eventually lined up with the long edge of the mat. Look over your right shoulder. Maybe eventually your chin comes over your shoulder as well. The seat firmly rooted on both sides. Come back, go to the other side. Left hand down, center of the back against the back, right hand to the other side of the left shin. Inhale, push the chest up, sit up tall, push the lower back in. Exhale, turn to your left. Feel the twist originating from the base of the spine. Feels you can see right through your skin and the spine just turning around itself. And release, slowly make your way down onto your back. So allow your feet to separate, ease your way down. Try not to drop down heavily again, just always soft movements. No jarring movements. And once you're down, just allow your hands to open up towards the sky, your palms facing up as though you're making a gesture receiving. It's exactly what you're doing in this pose, making yourself receptive to all the incoming gifts. Surrendering completely. Remove all the physical, mental, and emotional barriers. Yourself to receive the best of the best now. Direct it all to the spiritual heart, okay, in the center of the chest, and the right side of the physical heart. This is the residing place of the highest self of God. Bring your attention there. That's where all those benefits will go. Imagine that heart space growing ever larger, infinitely large, to fit all beings within. For in reality, God resides equally, in equal portion, in all beings everywhere. All beings lovingly in your heart. Compassion towards all beings, leaving no one out, nothing. All life. It's through this practice that we cultivate compassion, through imitation of the forms. Imitation is a very high form of obedience and reverence towards our teachers. Imagine all beings as our teachers, for we learn something from each and every one of them. Each is something special and unique to offer. So in light of that, make an intention to keep on cultivating compassion towards all. Say to yourself now the following sentence 3 times. I am grateful for all that all beings teach me. Remember to carry that out into your daily life now, in all your interactions. Look upon all beings with love, with compassion, with reverence. They are all divine reflections of the highest self within. So now prepare to exercise that. Return to a seated position, mindfully and gently, making your way back. Sitting up tall, supreme. Move with quietness, with reverence, with grace. Close the practice with Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Instill the peace within, send it out to all beings everywhere. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Divine grace of God, all is with.